said, Grandpa, what's this picture here? It's all black and white, and it ain't real clear. Is that you there? He said, yeah, I was 11. And times were tough back in 35. That's me and Uncle Joe just trying to survive a cotton farm and a Great Depression. If it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. This one is my favorite one. This is me and Grandma in the summer sun, all dressed up the day we said our vows. You can't tell here, but it was hot that June. That rose was red and her eyes were blue. And just look at that smile, I was so proud. That's the story of my life, right there in black and white. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. Thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray keep covered. You should have seen it in color. But you can't see what those shades of gray keep cover. You should have seen it in color.
Everybody, please rise as the bride makes her entrance. Invitation of Christopher and Jessica to celebrate with them one of life's most greatest moments, the joining of two hearts in marriage. Please be seated. It is one of life's most finest experiences when out of the routine of ordinary life, the extraordinary happens. You met each other, you fell in love, and now you are here finalizing it with your marriage. Today you are surrounded by your family and friends, all of whom are gathered to witness your marriage and to share in this joyous occasion. Life takes on meaning as it becomes composed of many meaningful events. Some of them can be planned, such as your wedding today. As you know, no minister, no priest, no rabbi, and no public official can marry you. Only you can marry yourselves. I'm going to hand your flowers. Face each other and join hands. By mutual commitment to love each other, to work toward creating an atmosphere of care and consideration and respect, by willingness to face the tensions and anxieties that underlie human life, you can make your wedded life come alive. True love serves as a common source of energy. From this day onward, you must come closer together than ever before. You must love one another in sickness and in health, for better and for worse. But at the same time, you must let your love give you the strength to stand apart so that each of you may seek out your unique destinies and make your special contributions to this world. Today, as you join yourselves in marriage, there is a vast and unknown future stretching out before you. The possibilities and the potentials of your married life are huge. And now it falls upon your shoulders the task of choosing values and making real of your dreams. You will please put your right palms together, right hand, left to left. This forms the infinity symbol with your hands, which symbolizes a love that will go on forever. These are the hands of your best friend. They are holding onto yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch, they will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief racks your mind. These are the hands that will give you strength just when you need it. May these hands always reach out with love, tenderness, and respect. And may these hands continue to build a loving relationship that lasts a lifetime. This time, I'll be asking for your consent. And you just will respond with, I do, if you give your consent. So Christopher, you're first. Christopher, do you take Jessica to be your wife, to live together in matrimony, to love, honor, comfort, and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Jessica, do you take Christopher to be your husband, to live together in matrimony, to love, honor, comfort, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Who has the rings? Rings? May I see them, please? It is custom to exchange rings as a symbol of love. As the ring has no end, so should your love have no end. As often as either of you see them, you'll be reminded of this moment and of the endless love you are promising today. So Christopher, if you will, please place Jessica's ring on her finger, look at her in her eyes, and repeat after me. May this ring forever be to you.
Forever be to you.
A symbol of my growing love.
A symbol of my growing love.
Thank you, Jessica. Please place Christopher's ring on his finger. Other hand. And repeat after me. May this ring. Forever be to you.
Forever be to you.
A symbol. Of my growing love.
Of my growing love.
As you have just sealed your relationship by the giving and the receiving of your rings, In the exchange of your vows, you have committed here to share your next day's sunrise and all of your days with each other. So if you will join hands. As of this moment, you are no longer two, but one. As you have consented to live in marriage and have pledged the same by the giving and the receiving of your rings. Are you ready? By the virtue of authority vested in me under the laws of the state of Florida, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Let me kiss your bride. Present to you for the very first time, Christopher and Jessica as husband and wife.
Thank you so much.
Thank you guys for all coming.
Thank you
very much. I'm so excited.
That you adore me, oh, when you kiss me. When you kiss me.